Lucky to be loving you. So lucky to be the one you run to see in the evening when the day is through. I only know what I know. The passing years will show. You've kept my so young and new.
Thank you, audience, and good evening, viewers. Please God, we've got some.
Well, you see, everybody's reading books these days, aren't they? They are. I mean, mostly them do-it-yourself books that they send you all that bumf about with that letter.
You know, you must have got it. Dear friend, we have selected you for this offer because of your above-average intelligence. Gee, I used to believe that until our producer got one. He got exactly the same letter. He brought it to me this morning. He showed it to me. He said, what does it say? But I'll send for them all, me, you know. The home doctor, the home winemaker. And if you get the home winemaker, you're going to need the home doctor. Yeah. Well, the home doctor came in, well, it came in very handy as soon as it arrived. The postman dropped it on my foot. We didn't really know which to sort out first, his face or my foot. But since I bought the home doctor, well, I've been able to tell all my neighbours what's wrong with them. I have. Some of them have taken it quite well. Yeah. One or two of them still managed to get out and do a bit of shopping. Yeah. Well, you see, I mean, people are losing faith in doctors these days, aren't they? I mean, you walk in and the first thing they say is, now, are you national health or do you want to be cured? Do you know, my dad, poor lad, my dad was under a specialist for 2 years with his back before they discovered he'd got his braces twisted. Hey, what? I mean, well, it's not nice, is it? But if you're really into human suffering, why don't you send for one of those books or roadmaps? Very reasonable. Of course they're reasonable. They're subsidised by the divorce lawyers. We know, don't we, girls?
Oh, you're right. I mean, it's terrible. He's driving away and you're sitting there. He chucks you a road mic and says, found out where we are. You're sitting there in this car. You've polished it, pushed it and paid for it. And now you've got to find out where it is. I mean, I always like that one, find out where we are. I mean, he's doing 90, and for all he knows, I mean, we're off the map and doing the little white bit round the edge. I mean, you look at this map. I mean, what are you looking for? There you are, you're going to visit Grace and Ernie. No mention here of Grace and Ernie's. Anyway, because, I mean, by the time you find it, I mean, he's doing 90 miles an hour, and, I mean, well, I mean, you're miles away. He says, I suppose we'll have to stop. Such emotion! I mean, you wouldn't think he was going to stop and look at a road map. You'd think he'd got cramp while he was making love to Britt Eklund. And there's another one, the wonders of nature. Oh, that's interesting. You learn some wonderful things. Did you know that the California midge fly gets up in the morning and mates 200 times a day? Fellas all over the world are wanting to find out what he has for breakfast. And did you know that if you travelled to the planet Jupiter, it would take you 100 million years, and it's made of gas? So when you get there, don't strike a match. No. Thanks to my do-it-yourself book, it's wonderful. I've managed to repair my own central heating, no trouble at all. Although I do get a few nasty letters, you know, from the Noise Abatement Society. Yeah, well, when it gets up steam, the radiator on the landing whistles Dixie. Yeah. And I've rewired my kitchen. Perfect. Perfect. Just one little thing. Sometimes when I'm washing up, I get this sensation like somebody's kicked me in the head, you know. But... and I must admit, the chap who came to fix the television seems to be a long time coming round. But actually, now that I'm sort of on my own, I thought, well, I'll employ one of these handymen. You know, because it's difficult, you know, you can't, can you? So I did, I said, well, her across the road, I mentioned it to her. She said, ooh, she said, no. You on your own, what will people think? A strange man in the house. I mean, she should talk. We all know it takes the fella all day to read her meter. It's true. And it took the Jehovah's nearly a week to get the witness back. Yes. Now, come on, all together and not at all. Anyway, I put an ad in the paper and, you know, for a handyman, and along comes this fella, middle-aged, average, respectable, unfortunately. And he said, well, you advertise for a handyman. What do you want me to do? I said, well, for a start, you could get up there and clean the gutters out. He said, I'm sorry, he said. No, he says, too dangerous. He said, I might fall down and kill myself, and after all I've got. I said, well, could you mend the fence, stop the dog getting out? He said, well, no. He said, but I could stand outside the fence and kick the dog back if it comes out. I said, no. I said, perhaps you could manage to paint the kitchen for me. He said, no. I'm sorry. He said, I'm allergic to paint. He said, one whiff and I'd be off for a fortnight. He said, then where would you be? He said. I said to him, look, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but as a handyman, you know, you appear to be about as much good as an ashtray on a motorbike. I said, you know. What gives you the idea, you know, you're handy? He said, well, I only live around the corner. Thank you very much. Since winning the Eurovision Song Contest, my first guests this evening have gone... well, they've gone on to become the most popular singing group in the country. Will you please welcome Bucks Fizz?
Hello, tapping at your window. the truth at 17, that love belongs to beauty queens and high school girls with clear skin smiles who marry young and then retire. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth were spent on one more beautiful. At 17 I learned the truth. And those of us with ravaged faces, lacking in the social graces, desperately remained at home, inventing lovers on the phone who called to say, come dance with me, and murmured vague obscenities. It isn't all it seems at 17. A brown-eyed girl in hand-me-downs, whose name I never could pronounce, said, pity please the ones who serve, they only get what they deserve. While the rich relationed hometown queen marries into what she needs with a guarantee of company and haven for the elderly. Remember those who win the game, lose the love they seek to gain, and aventures of quality and dubious integrity. The small town eyes will gape at you in dull surprise when payment due exceeds accounts received at 17. Of us who knew the pain of Valentines that never came, and those whose names were never called when choosing sides for basketball. It was long ago and far away, the world was younger than today, and dreams were all they gave for free. Ugly duckling girls like me.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome, playing his old composition, Harlequin, one of the world's leading flamenco guitarists, Juan Martin. Thank you.
sang to me. Sing your song, sweet music man, 'cause I won't be there to hold your hand like I used to. I'm through with you. You're a hell of a singer and a powerful man, but you surround yourself with people who demand so little of you. You touch my soul with your beautiful song. Said I need you. Then you changed the words and added harmony, and you sang the song you had written for me to someone new. Nobody sings a love song quite like you do. Nobody else can make me sing along. Nobody else can make me feel the things are right and I know they're wrong. Nobody sings a love song quite like you. Song, sweet music man. You travel the world with a six-piece band that does for you what you're asking to. And you try to stay young with the songs you sing to so many people who've all begun to come back on you. Sing your song, sweet music man. You're making your living. I don't need you. You're still a hell of a singer, but a broken man. But you keep on looking for one last band to sing to. Song, sweet music man, I believe in you.
Is feline and impossibly feminine. The reason why you can never be certain she's ever the same.
The panther is a wildcat woman. The panther is a wildcat woman. The panther is a wildcat woman in a wildcat world.
Panther is a wildcat woman. Panther is a wildcat woman. Panther is a wildcat woman in a wildcat world. The panther is a wildcat woman.
Cursing at your life, you're a discontented mother and a regimented wife. I've no doubt you dream about things you'll never do. I better wish someone would talk to me like I'm gonna talk to you. I've been to Georgia, California, and anywhere I took the hand of a preacher man, and we made love in the sun. I ran out of places, friendly faces, 'cause I had this need to be free. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. See, I have this need to tell you why I'm all alone today. And I can see so much of me still living in your eyes. Won't you share a part of this weary heart that has lived a million lives? I've been to Nice, the Isles of Greece, and I sipped champagne on a yacht. I moved like dressed by kings. I've seen some things that a woman ain't supposed to see. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. Better from the sweet. I've spent my life exploring, subtle whoring, but it costs too much to be free. Yes, I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me.
Thank you. Do you know, I first met my final guest about, 10 years ago when I was a comair of the Fiesta Club in Sheffield, and he was top of the bill. And, well, he's remained my top of the bill ever since. So it's with equal pleasure that I introduce him once again. Will you please welcome Mr. Gene Pitney?
When you're young and so in love as we, and bewildered by the world we see, why do people hurt us so? Only those in love would know what a town without pity can do. If we stop to gaze upon a star, people talk about how bad we are. Ours is not an easy age. We're like tigers in a cage. What a town without pity can do. The young have problems, many problems. We need an understanding hug. Why don't they help us, try to help us, before this pain, when it planet falls apart? Hey, these eager lips and hold me fast. I'm afraid this kind of joy can't last. How can we keep love alive? How can anything survive when these little minds tear you in two? What a town without pity can do. How can we keep love alive? How can anything survive when these little minds tear you in two? What a town without pity can do. No, it isn't very pretty. What a town without pity can do. Goodbye, Howard. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I knew Mary Lou right from the start. Hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, Howard. You passed me by one sunny day, flashed those big brown eyes my way, and ooh, I wanted you forevermore. Now I'm not one that gets around, trail my feet stuck to the ground, though I never did see you. Hello, Mary Lou.
Mary Lou.
Goodbye, Howard. Treat Mary Lou. I'm so in love with you.
I love you.
I knew Mary Lou. Right from the start. Hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, your voice. Believe me, I just had no choice. Wild horses couldn't make me stay away. I thought about a moonlit night, arms around me good and tight. That's all I had to see for me to say. I said, hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, Howard. Treat Mary Lou. I'm so in love with you. I knew Mary Lou.
Do you know that song brought back one or two memories for me? Every love affair leaves you with some memories, doesn't it? You know, I happened to make that remark to my agent and his eyes filled with tears and he showed me a faded photograph of his very first pound note. Mind you, I do feel a bit sentimental today because, well, today is the happy anniversary of my divorce. Yeah. It's a shame, really. I mean, at one time, the marriage vows meant something, didn't they? I mean, my mum and dad never considered divorce. Never. Murder, yeah, frequently, but divorce, never. Our marriage, you know, to tell you the truth, it was doomed from the start. His mother was against it. She turned up at the wedding and threw rice and sweet and sour, two portions of 20. It might have been 29. Anyway, it tasted like 20. And she cried. She cried so much at the church, she got invited to a funeral. She did. And I knew, you see, you can tell when the magic's gone, can't you? I knew the magic was fading when I'd go up to bed and he'd stayed downstairs to watch Crossroads. I knew. He was so immature and he never improved right from the very first time the vicar said, put away your beano and repeat after me. And then he wrote to Jim'll fix it for a divorce. I went to see the marriage guidance counsellor at the town hall, but owing to government cutbacks, well, they'd taken the battery out of his hearing aid. Yeah. And, well, to tell you the truth, conjugal rights is almost impossible to mime. Think about it. And, no, to tell you the truth, all I've got left is the very first poem he ever wrote to me. I've got it, excuse me. More rubber down there than Dunlop. Anyway, I always... Here it is. You know, I always carry it because in emergencies it doubles as a Kleenex. Hey, listen to this. Listen to this. Your hair is red, your eyes are blue, I love you from afar, and often wonder what you'd do for half a bounty box. Good enough. Romantic fool. And such a disappointment. No. I was always in love at school. I remember the first one was a boy called Candle Nose Wilson. Yeah. Well, he had overproductive sinuses. Yeah. When he sniffed, it sounded like somebody drinking a puddle sound. For his birthday, I bought him some of them capsules that dry your cold up. You know, it was awful. Stopped his nose running, but it all sort of backed up, and it took two of us to get his cap on. Then, when I was in the sixth form, there was Nathan Cohen. Now, he was born to be a great lover and a financial genius, yeah. On our very first date, he whipped his jeans off and sold them to me. Every night, do you know, I used to help him to carry his books home from school. I was doing it for a fortnight before I discovered we'd nicked the school library. Incidentally, it's rather a strange coincidence, you know, because Willie up there on the drums, he was in my class at school. He did. He had quite a name, he did. Hi, Willie. How many fingers am I holding up? Four. They are. Living proof, you don't go blind. He's changed, you know. In those days, in those days, he looked like a Greek god. He did. Look at him now, looks more like a Greek restaurant. Look at that. Then I fell in love with our science master. Yeah, do you know, I used to dream that we'd get married and together we'd make a great scientific discovery and cure Candle Nose Wilson. You know, all this talk of romance makes me think about a little chat I had with our producer just before the show. You see, we draw lots to see who's going to have a chat with the producer, and I lost. And anyway, he was telling me he's just been on a second honeymoon, and when they got to the hotel, he said to his wife, he said, now listen, you go up to the room, slip into the French maid's outfit with the free sheriff's badge, money back guaranteed if not delighted, while I nip to the bar for a quick pint of Filosan, and Bob's your uncle. So she goes up to the room, and no sooner had she laid down on the bed than a train goes by, and the whole room started shaking so much that crash bang wallop, she's on the floor. She phoned room service, and she said, room service, send me up another room. No, she didn't. I just put that in for a little laugh. Not as little as that, though. Anyway, it's too late. She told the manager all about it. She said, if you don't believe me, come up and see for yourself. So when he arrives, he said, when does the next train go by?
He said, she says it should be in about 3 minutes' time. So I said, right. He said, lay down here next to me and you'll see what happens. No sooner has he laid on the bed than who should come in but her husband, Thingy. He couldn't believe his eyes. I can't believe my eyes, he said. There, I told you he couldn't. What, might I ask, are you doing on the bed with my wife? And the fella said, you're not going to believe this, but I'm waiting for the 28th passport to Manchester.
Love on the rocks, ain't no surprise. Pour me a drink and I'll tell you some lies. Got nothing to lose, so you just sing the blues all the time. I gave you my heart, gave you my soul. You left me alone here with nothing to hold. Yesterday's gone. Now all I want is a smile. First they say they want you. You need, you can say what you want. Not much you can do when the feeling is gone. Maybe blue skies above, but it's cold when your love's on the run. Surprise. Pour me a drink and I'll tell you some lies. Yesterday's gone and now all I want is a smile.